Hello everyone, this is BCS Buster, and welcome back to Let's Play New Horizons. Last time, we gained a bunch of ships by winning our first duel, and we gained some more fame in piracy. If you remember at the end of last episode, I was just short of the fame of piracy that I needed to get to suppress my fame and adventure. So I went off-screen, and I won another battle there, and I got enough fame now. I'm up to 4,400 fame in piracy, so I'm good to go there. I also went and I got some more Venetians. I beat Kyra Din, and now I have 7 Venetians on my team. So that's pretty good. Up my flagship. Oops, that's not it. I up my flagship to the BCS. It's got some cannons on it now and some gunpowder, and I'm not ready to go. And I got 7 ships, so that's pretty exciting. I should be able to get the rest of the ships that I need. I'm going to go for 10 eventually. And I should be able to do that pretty soon. So we're doing really well, actually. Things are progressing quite nicely. So we're going to want to head back home now, and we'll get our new mission from the king. I'll just speed up here. And I'll just speed up through this real quick. I'm going to make a couple stops. Well, no, I'll make my stops a little bit later as I move along. I want to get my mission from the king as quickly as possible. Oops. That's not where I want to go. Here's where I want to go, is Amsterdam. All right. So let's first go up to the visit with the king. And let's see what our mission's going to be. Apparently the king's interested in meeting with us. Sounds good. Well, he's the governor general, but for our intents and purposes, he's the king. Okay, he's heard quite a bit about us. Okay, what can we do? Ah, the Italian fleet is making spaghetti, okay? Yeah, we'll go take out the Italian. Sure, why not? And if we do that, he'll give us a royal title. Sweet! Okay, well, let's check in with Mercator, see how he's doing. Okay. Oh, I always do the slow welcome we meet with Mercator. Who's the girl? Ah, Paula. Apparently he's Mercator, the famous cartographer. That's right. Oh, thank you. Yes, we're trying to help her find her homeland, if you remember. Well, this is kind of nice. Yeah, homeland, that's no big deal. Well, I hope you find it. Now, let's talk business. You know, it's kind of, he kind of just blows off that. No, 640 gold pieces. Great. A little more fame and adventure. He kind of just blew that off there as, oh, well, she just, that's really cute. Best of luck, you know, kind of deals. So, we need to go find an Italian fleet and beat them up. Sounds good to me. Let's do this. Okay. So, to do that, well, we're going to make a couple stops along the way, because we may be able to take some ships from them. Let's see what we got here. Oops. I may actually commit treason here in a minute. Nope, he's okay. There is a couple guys from my own country that I'm going to defeat, though, because I want to hire them on my team. Guys like Julian Felmer, who I've defeated several times before, and you've seen me do that. I'm going to make a couple stops. I want to stop here in London first. Who is this? Why is he hanging out? Oh, they're looking for the British. That's right, I forgot. Portugal's out to get Britain right now. Okay, so we're going to stop here in London real quick. And we're going to pick up Lawrence Edwards. Now we can hire him. He's a really good guy to have on your team. He has really good seamanship, and he has good levels. And there he is. And join the crew. 50 gold pieces? Sure, that sounds good. Okay, we're going to put him on a ship right away. Because he has very good seamanship, and he'll be a lot better than Antoine. Sorry, Antoine. Love you, but Lawrence is just better than you. And we're going to make a... We'll make Antoine my bookkeeper, because he's the only one that can really do that right now. But that will certainly change. Okay, we're doing good. Keep on going. I can now get another Venetian if I need it, which is always helpful. Okay, now we're going to go over and we're going to head over to Bristol, and we're going to pick up Anthony Morgan. Should be another good guy for us to hire. And I'll just speed that up real fast. Okay, going this way, and there's Bristol right up there. Hey, there's Dublin. I didn't realize I hadn't found that. Oh, and our Dante got another level. Excellent. Okay, so let's head up here to the cafe. And, oops. We're going to pick up another guy. Okay, so we'll go get Anthony Morgan, another great guy for you to have on your team. He's cheap, and he has really good seamanship. So you notice that I hire the same guys in every walkthrough. Because I really, there's only a handful of guys that I really feel are worth hiring. And he's 10 gold pieces. And, alright, another good guy to have on your team. Let's put him... Let's see if we need to get him on a ship right away. Nah, we'll just make him a chief navigator for now. And that'll be fine. We'll put him on a ship later. Actually, wait, no, just kidding. I'm going to have him replace Hans, because Hans isn't Hans. Hans, I think it's Hans. He's not great. And Hans can be my first mate. There we go. Good. Now, there's only one more guy that I need to hire, and then I'll have a crew of 10. So it'll probably be either a guy that I defeat and rehire, or I'll just find someone and hire them. Alrighty. We have 7 Venetians, and we're rocking and rolling. I like it. Oh, I know who the last guy I'm going to hire is. And I'm probably going to hire 2 more, just because Hans isn't great. I mean, he's okay, but... Okay, now we need to go find an Italian fleet, and find them and beat them up. The best way to do this is we're going to hang outside the port of Genoa, which is their home port, and one will eventually emerge. And it may take a little while for it to do that, so I'll probably just fast forward off screen or wait for one to show up. Sometimes it takes a little while. Sometimes you may just, just randomly run into one. That's probably a Spanish battle fleet. Yeah. So I always like to find out where who the guys are around us are, just so we know if there's anyone we need to defeat or take out or anything like that. So what I'm probably going to do is once I get this royal title, I'll just show you, I'm probably just going to spend a little time off screen getting a bunch of royal titles, and probably even achieving the rank of Duke before I even set sail on my adventures. And there's a very good reason for that. Don't need to worry about him just yet. Let's see, where's he heading? Just for curiosity. Antwerp. Okay, they're apparently out to get the Dutch for some reason. Fair enough. Wait, that's us. Wait, why does he have to get us? What do we do to him? Ah, there's Guido Benzo. There's an Italian fleet. Okay, I just gotta wait and fight him and take him out. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, viewers, is I'm gonna attack this guy, and then I'm gonna make my way back to Amsterdam, and I'll meet you there, and you just go back the same way that you came, and then we'll get our royal title from the king. So I'll meet you guys back in just a little bit. Okay, we've made it back, and let's go visit the king and get our first royal title. It's pretty exciting. And yes, I know, the king's interested in meeting with us. Sounds great. Okay, let's meet the ruler. Yes, thank you. And we're now a page. Page von Boer. Excellent. Now, what we want to do is we want to do a couple things. First thing we want to do is get a letter of mark. That's important because that'll get us more friendship with our country and more fame and piracy for every battle that we win. So that's important. That's a good thing to have. Now, tax-free permits are a little expensive, so we don't do those just yet. We're only allowed with 8 ports around the world. That's not great. I think they're all in Europe. Yeah, Antwerp. For some reason, they're going after Antwerp. But, there's a couple more. We'll have to go do some investing, and we can do that. But... So there's that, and tax-free permits are a little expensive right now, and we're not going to do any trading just yet. So we don't need to worry about tax-free permits for right now, but we will in just a little bit. I'll do some trading probably once October hits, because tax-free permits are issued in October and April. So I will just wait a couple months, and I'll show you where to get the tax-free permit. Okay, so what I'm probably going to do now is, probably the Governor General is looking for us, yes. So what you do now, folks, is you just go and you can just do this over and over again, defeat an enemy fleet, and eventually get royal titles, depending on how much fame and piracy that you get. What I'm probably going to do is, again, you could go and start the journey for Ernst von Boer and start going around and start, make a map of the world. I personally would wait just a little bit because we want to get... we want to get enough royal titles so that our eventually we're going to get a really cheap price on goods. And that's going to be important because we need to do some trading. And trading is going to help us get the capital that we need, the money that we need to fund our journeys. So what I'm probably going to do here is I'm just going to go off screen and get a couple more royal titles. If I have time in this episode... Actually, no. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and sign off. In the next episode, I will show you how... I will show you how much, or I'll show you my new royal titles, and then I'll show you the trade route that is necessary to start earning you a bunch of money. So, I look forward to seeing you in the next episode of Let's Play New Horizons. Until then, this is BCS Buster signing off. Take care, y'all.